Father, thank you for tonight. In the name of Jesus, we give praise. Shall we go ahead tonight and just begin to celebrate His mercy? Or welcome the Ember month. We step into September. Let's go ahead tonight and acknowledge His mercy, His goodness, His faithfulness, His wonderful love for His preservation. Let's bless His holy name. Oh, let's lift up our voice in thanksgiving. Let's lift up our voice in gratitude. And just appreciate Him. Let's appreciate our Maker. Let's thank Him. Let's thank Him. Let's thank Him. Oh, grande bossi della briga della bosca. Zero panica da briga della bosca. Rassi bo 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 bo. Oh, Father, we bless your name for the new month, the month of September. We are grateful for your faithfulness, for your preservation, for your goodness, for your wonderful love. Oh, for all you have done. Blessed be your holy name. Maru panica da briga della bosca. We receive the month of September with gratitude, Lord. Let's go ahead and appreciate Him and thank Him. And take hold of the blood of Jesus. Let's take hold of the blood of Jesus. Take hold of the blood of Jesus and sanctify every day of the month of September. Oh, with that precious blood. We sanctify the month of September, Lord, in the name of Jesus, with the blood of Jesus from the first day of Eden. To the last day of it, in the name of Jesus. We declare the month of September is sanctified. We remove every form of danger, every form of plan of the enemy, whatever the enemy has intended for our lives for the month of September. We cancel, in the name of Jesus, we destroy. We say, shall not stand, in Jesus' mighty name. Each day of September is sanctified. We release the blessing of September for the month of September, in the name of Jesus. We release all the blessings that God has in store for us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. So here's Kalabash in the moon. The blessings brought forth by the sun, the one brought forth by the moon. Lord, the blessings of the everlasting, the ancient mountains, the everlasting hill, the favor of Him that dwelleth in the bush for the month of September. Father, we release in the name of Jesus. Sir Ruska Alaboshina Alaboska, Rasa Brakente, Ruska Alaboska, Maka Setenebo. The grace of God for each day of the month of September. Lord, in the name of Jesus, the grace that we need. Nakuria Seba Kanya, Ruske Delebomushida Alaboske. Thank you. We shall mount on with wings like eagles. We shall run. We shall know the way. We shall walk and not faint. In the name of Jesus, we will possess our possession, we will take hold of all that belongs to us, we will recover all that we need to recover, physically, spiritually, in the precious name of Jesus. We decree ahead of time, concerning the month of September, that all things shall work together for our good. In Jesus' mighty name, we program the realm of the Spirit to bring forth the good things of God. We program the realm of the Spirit right now in the name of Jesus for the month of September to bring forth the blessing of God, the goodness of God, to bring forth favor in the name of Jesus. Spiritual program, we release that spiritual program to the month of September in the name of Jesus. And we cancel and destroy, we superimpose the blessing of God over every plan of Satan in Jesus' mighty name. Neruske de la Boske. Erega baba baba sinde rege le rege le lebo mari baba 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 zikia kuria la masende la boske roba baba baba senta la bilega masana la boske. In Jesus mighty name, hallelujah. Throughout over one month now, our effort has been directed towards steadying our mind as to the significance of Mount Zion, our coming to Mount Zion, The grace that we contact on Mount Zion, the blessing God has stored for us, the effect and the power and the blessing of Mount Zion. I want us to go ahead tonight. I want to pray and declare. We said, is it Isaiah 25? Isaiah 25. What God said, just prepare for us upon this mount, Mount Zion. In Jesus' name, we want to decree and declare that whenever we step into Mount Zion, in Jesus' mighty name, grace to lay hold upon the blessing that pertains to us upon this mountain. In Jesus' name, the veil shall be destroyed. The face of the covering shall be removed. In Jesus' mighty name. That whenever we ascend up to Mount Zion, we ascend them up to something higher, higher. We come up higher, 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 spiritually, in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Isaiah 25, beginning from verse 6. And in this mountain shall the Lord of hosts make unto all people a feast of fat things, a feast of wines from the leaves, of fat things full of marrow, and of wines from the leaves were refined. And he will destroy this mountain, the face of the covering, cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations. We go ahead tonight in the name of Jesus. Upon this mountain, no more veil. Hallelujah. Every congregant, every participant, everyone that has sent upon Mount Zion, in the name of Jesus, we decree and declare that veil shall be destroyed. As they step into the threshold of the church in Jesus' mighty name, Lord, let it be fulfilled concerning us, concerning all our sons and daughters, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that the face of the covering cast over all people shall be destroyed, and the veil that is spread over all the nations shall be removed in the name of Jesus. Ruskeva candele rubagadia, arugere megadi la bosca delle bosca, araba candabri e de bosca la bosca, i capro satake te te de bosca ta, araka breke te te de bruta mama 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 sobre gele la bosca la maka se te rega la se te bosca, maka se te rega la bosca la bosca, raga ba 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 ba. In the name of Jesus. Secondly, let's just pray and release Isaiah 2:2 shall come to pass in the last day that the mountain of the Lord house shall be exalted above the shall be established upon the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills and all nations shall flow into it. Let's decree that tonight. This is Mount Zion exalted above, set upon the mountains and exalted above the hills. It must be, because it's a supernatural institution. It is the institution of God Himself, ordination by divine ordination. Therefore, Mount Zion, the church of the living God, must of a necessity excel in excellence in every aspect, any ordinary institution, any institution formed by man. The church is of God. The church is Christ mystical. Therefore, of a necessity, it must be higher. It must be higher in excellence in every aspect. In the name of Jesus, and every nation, the Lord creates Kama Kada, Narus Kama, the first dominion return back to the church in the name of Jesus. The Rus Katata, Ikoli Bakandi, the Vodia Bakandi, Riska Baba 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 Baba, Maka Sete, the Bruder de la Mosca, and the worshippers upon this mountain as well. In Jesus' mighty name, an elevation, an elevation, an elevation. Oh, elevation of vision, elevation of their sight, wisdom and understanding, elevation to that of divine, supernatural, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Glory be to God. Let's just take one song as we worship God tonight. With our heart lifted up. Hallelujah. Thank you. man that was slain for the sin of the world. We have to let your presence, Lord. We have to let your mercy, Lord. We have to let your goodness, Lord.
The wisdom of God, the power of God,
Hallelujah. By which we are fully equipped to live in the natural, supernaturally, and to live in the supernatural, naturally. Hallelujah. And that's the church of the living God. Now, in 2 Chronicles 6:41, it says this: Now therefore, arise, O Lord God, into thy resting place, thou and the ark of thy strength. Let thy peace, O Lord God, be clothed with salvation. And let thy saints rejoice in goodness. Therefore, arise, O Lord God, into thy resting place, thou and the ark of thy strength. Let thy peace, O Lord God, be clothed with salvation. And let thy saints rejoice in goodness. With a heart full of reverence and the fear of God, and worship and gratitude and thanksgiving to God, we ascend up to Mount Zion. We ascend up to Mount Zion. And as we ascend Mount Zion in that attitude of heart, God by His Spirit arises into His resting place. God by His Spirit arises. And then the priest is clothed with salvation. When the Spirit of God begins to move, He equips His saint or His priest. The priest is equipped to minister supernaturally to the need of God's people. For salvation, deliverance, prosperity, name it. Salvation is one big word that covers all redemptive processes. It's not just being saved. It means supernatural provision. It means deliverance. It means protection. It means all that. When the priest is clothed with salvation, what we're saying is this: he's empowered. What we're saying is this: he's anointed. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are loose, and to announce the acceptable year of the Lord. And He pulled down the book and said, "This day this is fulfilled in your ears." What we are saying here is this: that when that happens, the saints will rejoice in goodness. They will become a partaker of the answers and solutions in the house of God. Deliverances, needs be met, answers, solutions are revealed. And it says they need to shout for joy. They rejoice in God's goodness. Glory be to God. That's the order of Mount Zion. That's the order of Mount Zion. That is the divine protocol. So that's why our heart must be prepared when we come to the church of Mount Zion, when we ascend Mount Zion. That's just something that came up as I was meditating. But we want to go a little bit further tonight, which is second to the last. God has reserved the best for you. The best to the last. John 2:10. He has reserved the best of the last. And the sweetest of the honey lies at the bottom. Glory be to God. So we're in the last days, isn't it? So anyway, I want to move without telling. I want to consider tonight another step or another blessing. Impact, effect, or significance of Messiah, as we look at the book of Isaiah, chapter 2, verses 2 and 3. Hallelujah. Isaiah 2, 2 and 3 is the prophecy for the church of the last days. The Jews divide this time into three. Before Christ, in the time of the law, and then the Messianic era, which is called the last days. So we are in the Messianic era, which is styled by the Hebrew or the Greek, sorry, the Hebrews, as the last days. Amen. The days when Messiah has come and his kingdom has come. So it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. And many people shall come and say, come ye, and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. The word of the Lord from Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Now, like I was saying when I began, I said, the church is of a divine institution. Then our stock in trade must also be of the same type. Hallelujah. Divine, supernatural. It must be divine, it must be supernatural. So the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3, 15, 17, 16, 17, reading from, I will read from two versions, 2 Timothy, I will read from Amplify, 3:16. Every scripture is God-breathed, given by the His inspiration, and profitable for instruction, for reproof, and conviction of sin, for correction of error, and discipline of obedience, and for training in righteousness, holy living, in conformity to God's will, in thought, purpose, and action, so that the man of God may be complete and proficient, well-fitted and thoroughly equipped for every good work. Well-fitted, thoroughly equipped. I love the way J.B. Phillips put it. He said, all scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching the faith, correcting error, for resetting the direction of a man's life, and training him in good living. The scriptures are the comprehensive equipment of the man of God, and fitting fully for all the branches of his work. He had a comprehensive equipment. So, in other words, John 6:45 says, we are his disciples, we are his disciples, we are the children of God. His disciples taught of God. Isaiah 54, verse 13. When we assemble Zion here, we are here to be a king. For whatever branch of work God has called us into. And the equipment is not just going to be natural alone. It's both supernatural and natural. Which is why we are thoroughly equipped and fitted for that work, the branch of work which we are called. We cannot but dominate. We cannot but rise up to the top. In whatever profession or whatever branch of work is allocated to us. Because it's not only dealing with natural equipment, skill, we're dealing with the anointing that will help us in that particular field to be the best, to do that which no man can do ordinarily in an apparent sense. So we're saying here that Messiah has been ordained of God for us an institution, divine institution, for the equipping of the saints. So, Mount Zion, therefore, because it's of divine origin, cannot just be ordinary. Hallelujah. It is a supernatural institution. And then, because it is supernatural, because it's the mystical Christ. When I say mystical Christ, 1 Corinthians 12:12. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 12:12. For as the body is one, has many members, what the members of that body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ. Do you see that? The church is Christ mystical, and we are his body. Hallelujah. So, if that is the case, don't forget this. The church must be of excellence, must rise beyond the natural in evidence, in prominence, and must be exalted above every effort and human institution. Hallelujah. Because it's of Christ. And remember in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 and 6, it says, even when we were dead in sins, has quickened us together with Christ. By grace I will say it. And has raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. That is the exhortation of the people of God. With Christ, who is the head, we are the body. Hallelujah. In eminence, in graces, in all aspects, we should excel as the people of God. As the people of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So let's go step by step tonight. Amen. So it is a prophecy about the church, that is Isaiah 2. But Mount Zion is the center for equipping the saints with wisdom and revelation of it. The training stock, therefore, upon Mount Zion must be of divine. Excellence must be divine in origin. We're talking about wisdom for which he mentioned. We're talking about supernatural knowledge and intelligence, about issues of life, superior mentality, and the religion must be will be released. Sorry, upon Messiah. Upon Messiah. It is our solemn assembly, our solemn holy convocation, where God calls his people together to serve him in his kingdom. Remember, I think it's in Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 12. A glorious high place from the beginning is the place of our sanctuary. A glorious high place. It's upon Mount Zion that God calls us all. Come up hither. Come up hither. Come up to a higher place of grace, higher place of service, higher place. Therefore, we are sent, spiritually speaking, unto Mount Zion to have fellowship with God, our Maker. We are sent from Mount Zion to have fellowship with our Maker. Hallelujah. Now, the church in prophecy, it is said about the church in prophecy, Ephesians 3:10. I read it from the Amplified Version. It said, the purpose is that through the church, the complicated, many-sided wisdom of God, in all its infinite variety and innumerable aspects, might now be made known to the angelic rulers and authorities, principalities, and powers in the heavenly sphere. Did you catch that? That the church, the body of Christ. Because what the stock in trade upon Mount Zion It's not just something ordinary. It is the wisdom of God dispensed to us in covenant form. It is the wisdom of God. And the wisdom of God, remember, I think it's in 1 Corinthians chapter 2. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 6. 1 Corinthians 2, verse 6 to 7. Let's just read verse 6 to 7. It says, yet when we are among the full-grown, spiritually mature Christians, we arrive in understanding. We do impart a higher wisdom, the knowledge of the divine plan, previously hidden. But it is indeed not a wisdom of this present age, or of this world, nor of the leaders and rulers of this age, who have been brought to nothing, and are doomed to pass away. But rather, what we are setting forth is a wisdom of God, was hidden from the human understanding, and now revealed to us by God. That wisdom which God devised and decreed before the ages for our glorification, to lift us into the glory of his presence. Do you understand that? That whenever this glory, this wisdom is unfolded, it will bring glory to him. We will not only be glorified, but it will bring glory to him. Whenever we lay hold upon this wisdom, the revelation we're talking about, it is beyond the capability of Satan and his angels or his demons. It's far, far superior. That's why the Bible says the church will teach the principalities and powers, the innumerable, many-sided wisdom of God. Hallelujah. So it is upon this Mount Zion that we are equipped with such insight and wisdom. Wisdom, supernatural answer. We are equipped with wisdom, insight, revelations, and so on, which are meant to equip us to solve the problem in the society, to solve the problem in your office place, in your workplace. God will deliberately create some problem at work, which only you, because you are there. But your promotion is around the corner, you can create some problem. And the answer lies with you, only you. Like he did for Joseph. Hallelujah. So it therefore behoves us as people of God for that level of sensitivity. So that when we come upon Mount Zion, we are here for the acquisition of spiritual technical skill and spiritual intelligence for invention, for commerce, for economics, for economic prowess, political knowledge, know-how upon this mountain. Every field of human knowledge, if we are so minded, and we come expect, pray don't come upon Mount Zion expecting such. God will meet us at our point of need. It's because we have misunderstood the purpose of church. We think it's just a mere social gathering. The church of the living God is not a social gathering. It's something beyond social gathering. It is more than social gathering. Much more than that. Hallelujah. It is not just for us to come and mark time. So it is therefore necessary for us as people of God that we prepare ourselves as we come to church. As if you are going for a promotion, an interview for promotion. Hallelujah. Be expectant to hear the answer. Be expectant to receive solution to problems, both for work, both at your workplace, and for the society. The world is waiting for the darkness. They will solve the political problem, the political compass. Our world is still waiting for a Joseph, who is there to solve economic problems. Hallelujah. And all these are necessary for us as the people of God. The word is waiting that we arise and demonstrate again the wisdom of God in politics, in economics, in entertainment, and all aspects of the mountains of the society. Our world is waiting for us. Our world is waiting for us. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Now, let's look at this. Exploit in life, therefore, is not just a product of natural knowledge. It's a product of spiritual knowledge. Praise God. Exploit in life. Daniel 11:32. This is very clear. And such as my lady called them in sharp about and said this was flatness. But the people who know their God shall prove themselves strong and shall stand firm and do exploit for God. So it's not just a product of natural knowledge, it's a product of supernatural knowledge. That is a knowledge beyond reason. I mean our intelligence. That is a knowledge beyond that. That's what Daniel operated in Babylon. In Daniel chapter 2. Daniel chapter 2. And this is available for us upon Mosiah. Daniel chapter 2. We start from Daniel 2. Remember the case where the king has the dream. And the dream is gone away from him. You know how quick it is for experts, so-called experts, in all manners of things, to conclude and bring up their judgment and declare that it is impossible, it cannot be done. I mean, think about it. In the medical profession, they will tell you this is beyond, it is medically nobody can solve it. Even as sophisticated as we are today, I see issues that the doctor will tell you this is impossible, impossible. And when situations like that arises, it is not meant for the people of God, it is meant for the world. We know that when men say there is no way, God can make a way. Hallelujah. We are not limited to that. We are not limited to that. We are not limited to their conclusions. Praise God. Let me see what I'm trying to bring out here. In Daniel chapter 2, when the king, I mean, he had a dream, the dream was not from him, and then he now called upon his wise men and the Chaldeans and all astrologers and said, tell me the dream and interpretation. The book said, tell us the dream and then we'll tell you the interpretation. He said, well, they are bidding on time. Now, there's one sentence for all of them, death. And then the Chaldeans look at the king and said, and the Chaldeans answer before the king and said, there is not a man upon the earth that can show the king's matter. Therefore, there is no king, lord, no ruler that has such things in any, at any magician or astrologer or Chaldean. It is a real thing that the king required, and there is none other than that can show it before the king, except the gods whose dwelling is not with the flesh. Can you imagine that? They have concluded that this solution, this problem cannot be solved. It is impossible. No human being has ever known it before, and it cannot be done. And when the world concludes like that, it is the opportunity for us to demonstrate that we have, we serve in God. Hallelujah. We can give us answer for every situation, every dead end issues of life. In verse 20, verse 22, 20, Daniel answered and said, blessed be the name of God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his. And he changed the times and the seasons. He removed kings and set it on kings. He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding. He revealed the deep and secret things. He knoweth what is in the darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. I thank thee and praise thee, O God, O thou God of my fathers, who has given me wisdom and might and has made known unto me now what we desire of thee. For thou hast now made known unto us the king's matter. What am I driving at? I'm bringing this to us to let us know that these are the stock in trade upon Mosiah. That issues that are complicated, issues that men have concluded and gave their verdict, impossible, irreversible. We can trust God and come upon Mosiah to receive answers and solutions. Hallelujah. That I didn't have the Spirit of God the way we have him today. And yet he was able to bring up the answer. By God showing him the solution and the answer. I will have the Holy Spirit today. Who can help us? Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. And I said that type of answer or solution we are talking about is only possible through supernatural knowledge. Supernatural knowledge. The exploit we are talking about is the knowledge of God. The knowledge of God, which is far, far above the natural wisdom, the natural knowledge. Hallelujah. In Proverbs chapter 3, verse 19, it says, the Lord laid the earth's foundations. I'm reading from TPT. What is the TPT?
Passion.
The Passion Translation. Hallelujah. The Passion Translation. My Lord laid the earth's foundations with wisdom, with wisdom blueprints. By his living, understanding all the universe came into being. By his divine revelation, he broke open the hidden fountains of the deep, bringing secret springs to the surface as the mist of the night drink down from heaven. Hallelujah. It takes supernatural wisdom to solve certain problems that is above the natural. We can operate on a supernatural plane to bring out the answer. Hallelujah. That's what that proverb is talking about. It is spiritual knowledge we are dealing with here, stock in trade, not just natural knowledge. Amen. And the same Proverbs 6, if you read verse beginning from 20, Proverbs 6, 20. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And this is why in these last days, because we live in the last of the last days, he says, my son, keep thy father's commandment and forsake not the law of thy mother. Bind them continually upon thy heart and tie them about thy neck. When thou wast, it shall lead thee. When thou sleepest, it shall keep thee. And when thou awakest, it shall talk with thee. That's the knowledge of God. Meditate it before you sleep. And pray it and ask for solution for a particular issue. The Bible says it will talk with you. Will talk with you. Hallelujah. When you are asleep, when you are awake, it will guide you. That's why in verse 3 of that Isaiah, that's no wonder why many people shall come and say, come, let us go. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 3. Because of they will see the result produced, definite result produced by people from Mosiah, which no natural knowledge can produce. When men are saying there is a casting down, they are saying there is a lifting up. They see the demonstration of it in your life. How are you making it? Say, well, you follow me to church. Hallelujah. Go with me. And many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his path. For out of Zion shall go forth the Lord, and the word of the Lord, from Jerusalem. That agrees with the prophecy of Zechariah in chapter 8 verse 20 to 23. Zechariah 8, 20 to 23. It's much saying, thus said the Lord God of hosts, it shall yet come to pass that there shall come people and inhabitants of many cities. And inhabitants of one city shall go to another, saying, let us go speedily to pray before the Lord and to seek the Lord of hosts. I will go also. Yea, many people and strong nations shall come to seek the Lord of hosts in Jerusalem and to pray before the Lord. Thus said the Lord of hosts, in those days it shall come to pass that 10 men shall take hold out of all the languages of nations, even shall take hold of the skirt of him that is in Jew, saying, we will go with you, for we have heard that God is with you. Their testimony is that we will go with you. We have seen the evidence that God is with you. Because what we see about you is supernatural. It's not natural. How can you be making it when everybody is crying, when economies are crashing and busting? You are making it. There's something about you. We have heard that God is with you. Therefore, we will follow. We will follow. And these are the last of the last days. And this pertains to us as the people of God. And as we round up tonight, I read from Obadiah, the prophecy of Obadiah. As saviors are rising upon Mount Zion, as deliverers are rising upon Mount Zion, this is what pertains to us as the heritage. It is our birthright. We need to understand this. We need to stir up ourselves. We don't have to sleep upon our right anymore, people of God. We need to wake up from slumber. Oh, what opportunity would be this. We just come to church just for the purpose of marking register. Hallelujah. Chapter Obadiah 17. We'll read it to 20, 21. It says, but upon Mount Zion, listen close, shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. What is our possessions? All that pertains to us in God. Not just the natural, the supernatural. Hallelujah. And the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Israel for stubble, and they shall kindle in them and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Israel, for the Lord has spoken it. And they of the house of the south shall possess the mount of Israel, and they of the plain of the Philistines. And they shall possess the field of Ephraim, and the fields of Samaria, and Benjamin shall possess Gilead. And the captivity of the host, of this host, of the children of Israel, shall possess that of the Canaanites, even unto Sarephath. And the captivity of Jerusalem, which is Sephard, shall possess the cities of the south. And Samuel shall come up on Mount Zion to judge the Mount of Israel, and the kingdom shall be to all. Savior shall come up upon Mount Zion. Deliverance. I think that's also quoted in one of the ways. There's somewhere in where it's quoted. Verse 20, 21, James 5, 20. It's quoted, Saviors will rise up upon Mount Zion. People of God, this is our privilege. This is what God has prepared for us upon Mount Zion. These are the things that God has made ready for us. All things are ready. They are waiting upon us. But it's a need for us to stir ourselves up. It is our time. These are all that pertains to us in God. Let us be mindful of this thing. Let us arise as indeed the saints of the battle to possess all that is that pertains to us in God. For upon Mount Zion, that will be delivered. It is in the house of God. It is in the church of God. I mean, what I've enumerated from the beginning tonight is just the fact that our stock in trade upon Messiah is supernatural. These are the days where we say the seven mountains of the society must be taken over by the church. If Christ, if the church is the Christ mystical, and we're his body, the excellency of the church, the prominence of the church, must reflect in his body as well. Therefore, we are saying that the church, which are the people of God, are going to rise up to take the seven mountains of the society. May this be fulfilled concerning us. May this be fulfilled concerning the covenant of church. We have been saved, and I believe this is the mind of God to us. This is the heart of God for us. As his own people. Let us not be remiss. Let us wake up to our privileges in God. Hallelujah. And Father, we bless you. Once again, for reminding us of our privileges, our right, upon Messiah. But it is you have prepared for us. But we pray for the grace so that we'll be able to prepare ourselves to receive what you intend for us to receive. To become what you intend for us to become. As saviors upon the seven mountains of influence of the society. Lord, in the precious name of Jesus, I pray tonight that, Lord, the days are here and that your men, your people are stirring up themselves. It's stirring them in the heart of the people. What if you can do it for a hidden king, Cyrus? How much more will people? I'm asking to them, Lord, begin to stir the heart of your people. Let them respond to this message. Let them see their privileges. Let them be able to step into it. In the precious name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of slumber. I come against the spirit of idleness, which comes upon people as an armed man, holding them in captivity. Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, I say, this is the hour. Let Zion awake. Let Zion put on strength and take hold of that which belongs to them. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Quickly, let's take our seat tonight and just bless the Lord with our seed. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Praise God. Let's take out the church seat tonight. Luke 6:38, give it shall be given to us. Good men, your press down, shake it together, and only over men we give to our bosom. But with what measure you meet, it shall be measured back to you. So, as we take that seat tonight, let us pray and release and trigger a blessing. Good men, press down, shake it together, and only over. We speak to the seat to go forth tonight in the name of Jesus. Men will know not. Lord, the Spirit is nudging them. There is a stir in the heart of men. Lord, to give to our bosom. Good men, you press them, shake it together, and run away. We decree and declare, favor is being stirred up for us in the name of Jesus. By reason of this seed tonight, in the name of Jesus. Supernatural wisdom and knowledge. Supernatural intelligence in the name of Jesus. To bring answers and solutions to the problem of society is being stirred up for us. In the name of Jesus. Zeruska labo shida la laboska. Mendoria kedeva shida labo sis laboska. Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory, 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 glory. Grace to rise to the top. Grace to rise to the top. To power me and to be a power me. Trade blessing grace. Father, we release tonight. Oh, as we drop our seed, as we seed into your kingdom, everything brings forth after its kind. Lord, let this seed bring forth after this kind, after this order, as we are praying tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. There is one more I think I want to consider on Mount Zion, which is just the gathering, the different people that gathers upon Mount Zion. But because we might not be able to do that, but I might put it into writing. But if as God has me, but I think we should move on to something else. I believe we have heard enough about the advantages of our gathering together with Mount Zion. We can call it here and pause it here as the Lord helps. Like I said, if I'm able to put it to writing, I'll write it and then we'll be distributed. That is talking about Hebrews chapter 12, verse 18 to 24, the comparison of the old with the new. You are not common to more that cannot be touched, and so on and so forth. And then you are common to heavenly, to the city of the living God, heavenly Jerusalem. As God helps, we might be able to put it into writing. Amen. Sunday is our Thanksgiving service, like we announced. As Pastor announced on Sunday, let's prepare to come and celebrate. Please send your testimonies. Write and send your testimony ahead of time. Hallelujah. Amen. And then, if you have not yet, send your email address for us to take the database for the for us to update our database. Please do. We appreciate that. God bless you for being part of tonight's meeting. Shall we share the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit remain and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, His goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I will remain and abide in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. Hallelujah.